Actually, in chat, once again, you can reply your answer because we have started one second this Zoom session. So previous chat is not there. So type your answer quickly. One first for first one, third one, fifth one. So unique, infinite, and no solution we have understood. So for consistent, if it is coming either unique or infinite solution, so consistent. And if it is coming no solution, so inconsistent. Okay, Diksha, what your answer? Good than waste your food. First three and fifth number. Solve and determine the answer. Okay, Ashish, consistent, inconsistent, consistent. Last 1 minute for those who have not replied yet. Very important because this week we have different questions from these topics only. So first one, let us try. First one is A1 by A2, A is 3 and B is 2. So 3 by 2 and B1 by A2 will be, B1 and B2 are coefficients of Y. So 2 and minus 3, 2 and minus 3. And C1 by C2 is 5 and 7, 5 and 7. You see first A1 by A2 and B1 by B2, A1 by A2 and B1 by B2. So A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by A2, no need to check C1 by C2. So if we can say not equal, so unique solution, hence consistent. Third one, 3 by 2, that is A, this 3 by 2 is A, divided by A2, this is A1, A2 is 9, B1, that is 5 by 3, B1 is 5 by 3 and B2 is minus 10, C1 is 7 and here it is C2 is 14. So we can check the values first. So this will be this 3, 3 is 9, 3, 3 is 9. 5 to 10 and 7 to 14. So first value will be this 3 and these 2 will be multiplied. This 3 and these 2 will be multiplied. So this will be 1 by 6. 1 by 6. 1 second. So you can refer your textbook because first one was unique or consistent, Second one was, first one, let me write one second, 3x plus 2y equal to 5. And then we have 2x minus 3y equal to 7. So we can write here a1 is 3, a2 is 2, and b1 is 2 minus 3. First we have to check this only. So a1 by 2 not equal to b1 by b2. So unique solution, and unique solution is comes under consistent pair of equations. Second one is 3 by 2 x plus 5 by 3 y equal to 7. And one more equation, 9x minus 10 y equal to 14. These are the two equations. Again, we see a1 by a2 first and b1 by 2. This is a1, a2 is 9, and this is b1, b2 is minus 10. So, 3, this will cut, 3 is a 9, and 5 is a 10. This 3 and this 2 will be multiplied, so 1 by 6. Here, this 3 and 2 will be multiplied, but minus 1 by 6. So, minus 1 by 6 will not be equal to 1 by 6. So, not equal. So, again, unique solution, and again, consistent. Again, unique solution, and again, consistent. Now, for third one we have, this means fourth one, this was the third case, fifth one we can say from our textbook. So for fifth one, 4 by 3 x plus 2y equal to 8, and second equation is 2x plus 3y equal to 12. So these are the two equations. We check a1 by a2, a1 is 4 by 3, a2 is 2. A1 and A2 are coefficients of X. B1 is 2 and B2 is 3. First we'll check these two values, A1 by A2 and B1 by A2, whether they are equal or not. So let me solve this. 2 will cut 4. 2 by 3, you can see 2 by 3, 2 by 3 equal. So they are equal. Now, once they are equal, we'll check third one, third number, that is, third one is 8 by 12. Or we may say minus 8 by 12 or 8 by 12, same thing, because both will go in left hand side to become minus 8. And minus 12, directly also will write 8 by 12, not a problem. 4 2 is 8, 4 3 is 12. So this will not be equal. Again, sorry, they are equal. So all the three values are equal. 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So all the equal are, that means infinite many solution. So again, consistent. Infinite many solution. So again, consistent. So first one is consistent. Second one is also consistent. And third one is also consistent. Third one is fifth one. First, then third, and then fifth. All are consistent because first and third was unique solution. And then in fifth case, we have infinite many solutions. So all three are consistent. All three. Last case, you want to explain one second. See. Okay. Diksha answer is correct. Tanvi also correct. Steve answer is. Steve, fifth one will be consistent only because, let me explain. Both are, all the three cases are consistent. See, for first one, we can write this now, A1, A2, B1, B2 values. See, for first one, suppose first one is, you know, A1 is 3, B1 is 2, C1 is 5. Like, we can write like this because comparing with the standard equation AX plus BY plus C equal to 0. So this will be A1, B1, C1. This is the first one, A1X plus B1Y plus C1. And second one will be A2X plus B2Y plus C2 equal to 0. Basically, A1 and A2 are the coefficient of X, values associated with the X. B1 and B2 are the values associated with Y. And C1 and C2 are constant term. A1, A2, X associated with X. So A1, B1, C1 will return 3, 2. And 5, or we can write minus 5, not an issue. But this 5 will go in left hand side to become minus 5. This will become minus 7. A2 is 2. B2 is minus 3. एन सी टू इज 7 और वी कैन राइट माइनस 7 माइनस नो प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज बोथ आर नेगेटिव. नाउ वी विल टेक रेशियो फर्स्ट ऑफ ए वन बाई ए टू एंड विल सी इट इट इज इक्वल टू बी वन बाई टू और नॉट. सो ए वन बाई टू इज 3 बाई टू कॉमा बी वन बाई टू इज 2 बाई माइनस 3 और माइनस 2 बाई 3 2 बाई माइनस 3 और माइनस 2 बाई 3. So this implies we can write a1 by 2 not equal to b1 by b2. Hence we can say unique solution because this is our case for unique solution a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. And for unique solution we write consistent pair of equations. This was the first one. Now for third one this is the question. Once again we write a1 value 3 by 2 b1 value 5 by 3 and c1 value 7 or minus 7. No problem. A1 is 3 by 2, b1 is 5 by 3, c1 is minus 7, a2 is 9, b2 is minus 10, and c2 is 14. So we can say, we'll try first value of a1 by a2 that is equal to 3 by 2 by 9. So this will be 3 3 3 3 9. 2 will come down. 2 will come down. So 1 by 2 into 3 6. 1 by 6 because 2 will come down. See, we can write this as 1 by 2 by 3. So what does it mean? 1 by 2 into 3. This 2 will come down. So 1 by 6. 1 by 6. And b1 by b2 will be equal to 5 by 3 and here it is minus 10 5 by 3 and minus 10 5 by 3 and minus 10. So 5 by 3, so this will cut 5 to the 10. So it will be 1 by 3 by minus 2 1 by 3 by minus 2. Again this 3 will come down, so it will become minus 1 by 6 or 1 by minus 6, minus 1 by 6 or 1 by minus 6. So this is a1 by 2, 1 by 6. This is b1 by 2, minus 1 by 6. Hence we can write again a1 by 2 not equal to b1 by b2. Hence we can say unique solution, and unique solution comes under consistent pair of equations because this 2 will come down. So 2, 3 is 6. 3 will come down, 3 minus 2. Equal to minus 1 by 6. Now coming to fifth one. Again we write a1 value that was 4 by 3. This value b1 is 2, c1 is minus 8, b1 is 2, c1 is minus 8. But this 8 will come in left hand side in standard equation. This 2 will also come in left hand side. Now this is a1, b1, c1. a2 is 2, b2 is 3, and c2 is 12. C2 is 12, or minus 12, we can say minus 12 because both 8 and 12 will go in left hand side. a2 is 2, b2 is 3, and c2 is minus 12, minus 12. Now we can find the values of a1 by a2 first. So a1 by a2 will be 4 by 3 by 2. What is the method? Simply we can write 4 by this 3 will come down 4 by 6. So this will be 2 by 3 because both this one 2 will come 2, 2 is a 4, 2, 3 is a 6. Now we find b1 by b2 value. So b1 is 2, 3 is normal value, right? You can write. Last one is c1 by c2. C1 is minus 8, c2 is minus 12. C1 is minus 8, and c2 is minus 12. So minus minus cancel and 4 2 is 8, 4 3 is 12. So again 2 by 3. Hence we can write a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by a2. And if it is equal, then we have to check c1 by c2 also. C1 by c2 is also equal. So solution is infinite many solution or infinite solutions or infinite many solution, and it also comes under consistent. So we can write consistent pair of equations. Consistent means consistent pair of equations. Consistent means consistent we can write, or we can write pair of equations are consistent. Proper is pair of linear equations are consistent. Consistent is for linear equations. If they are having unique solution or infinite solution, so they are consistent. So pair of linear equations we can say consistent. Here also we can say pair of, in short I am writing LE, linear equations are consistent. Here also pair of linear equations are consistent. These are the three cases. Just need to find the values of A1 by A2, B1 by A2, and C1 by C2 to know the results. Is not the solution. We'll see one last question for today, and then we'll listen. In next class, we'll try to complete remaining questions of 3.2. A1 by A2 value, B1 by A2, and C1, C2 are just where to find, and then we can take the ratios. If A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by A2, directly we can write unique solution or consistent. If A1 by A2 equal to B1 by A2 equal to C1 by C2, all are equal. So infinite many solutions. And last one, A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2. So last we have not, so no solution. A new solution is only case of inconsistent. Otherwise, for unique solution and infinite many solution, linear equations or pair of linear equations will be consistent. Now, our last question for today. Everyone will try. And for this question, we don't have any one answer. Let me write the question. So, question is: suppose we have the linear equation 2x plus 3y minus 8 equal to 0. This is given. And we have to write another equation. The question is write another linear equation in two variables. Two variables are x and y. X is one variable, y is another variable, such that the pair, so formed, pair means one equation is given, one more equation you have to write. So pair formed is first intersecting lines, second one parallel lines, third one coincident lines. Otherwise, we can note the question, and then this we can try as a homework. This question. Just I will explain in 1 minute because we have very less time left. So say 2x plus 3y minus 8 equal to 0 is one equation. One equation in two variables, x and y are two variables. And what is the question? Write another equation. One more equation we have to write, linear equation in two variables means in x and y, such that in two variables, such that the pair so formed is first, it should be intersecting in first equation. In first equation should be such that both the pair should be have intersecting lines, then parallel, and then coincident lines. Then parallel, and then coincident lines. Note the question. And then you can try as homework. In case any doubt, then you can stay back. Otherwise, you can end the session. Tushar, you can stay back. Others, if any doubt, then you can stay back. Any students can end the session after noting the question. So Tushar, in today's session, we have studied is the methods of finding whether this pair of linear equation will have unique solution or infinite many solution or no solutions. So methods we had this one seen in your today's session. Suppose let me open this one second. This inside the book. Or here also we can see because okay, Diksha sent one answer. No problem. We'll discuss in our next class. Keep it with you yourself, and we'll check. Most probably it seems correct one, but we'll discuss in our Friday session. Okay. So Tushar, I'm sharing this one whiteboard. See. So mainly pair of linear equations will have three kinds of solution. First of all, pair of linear equations represented by ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This is, you can say, standard form of representing one linear equation in two variables are x and y. Suppose for example we have 2x minus 3y equal to 5. This is one equation. So we can represent in standard form by writing like this: 2x minus 3y minus 5 equal to 0. This 5 will come in left hand side. Minus 5 equal to 0. Right. So this is the one case. Now suppose we have two equations. So two equations can be represented by like this: a1, a, b, c are constant values. So in place of for first one, we can write a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. For second one, we can write a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. And then we can compare the values. So we first will find a1 by a2 value. First find. Then we'll find b1 by b2 value. And then we'll find c1 by c2 value. Ratio of a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. This is the first step. And if you compare, if after finding, if a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2, if we found this a1 by a2, b1 by a2, and c1 by c2, first we will find a1 by a2 and b1 by a2. If they are not equal, so then we have unique solution. Unique solution is one solution. Unique solution is one solution. And how these lines will come? Because both the equations will have line L1, line 2. Both will have, if you draw graphically, if you draw, then you get a line. So this type of lines will come. Line L1 and line L2 will be like this for unique solution or infinite. Unique solution basically, not infinite, unique solution, it will cut at one point. And unique solution is also called, will come under consistent. Consistent means equation will be called as consistent. Equations, pair of these equations will be called as, they are consistent equations. So consistent pair of linear equations. Correct. Now, suppose this was the first case. Suppose you found the values and second case, if a1 by a2, it's coming equal to b1 by b2, not equal to, in previous case we had not equal to. So a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. So unique solution and consistent, we can call pair of linear equation as consistent for the unique solution. In the second case, we can say if they are equal, and last one is also equal, c1 by c2 is also equal, all are equal. So we have infinite many solutions, and this also comes under consistent. So we can write consistent only. Consistent, what consistent? Consistent pair of linear equations. Consistent pair of linear equations. And Okay, consistent pair of linear equation because all the threes are equal and line will be like this. They will be coinciding. So this is line L1. So second line L2 will lie exactly one above the other. Second line L2 will lie exactly on top of the first line. So suppose here we have the line L1. So second equation will lie exactly on L1, L2. So that's why these will be we can say infinite many solution. And why? Because many points, all the points will be common to both the lines. Why common? Say here only one point is common. This point is lying on both the lines. Here in the second case, many points will lie on the both the lines. So it means many common points are there. So many solutions are infinite many solutions. We had only one point common, so one solution. In this case, many points are common, so more solution or infinite many solution. Third case, let me write. If a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2, but not equal to c1 by c2. At the end, not equal to c1 by c2. So not equal to means no solution. No solution. And only no solution. In this case, no solution, we write inconsistent. Inconsistent, not consistent. Inconsistent pair of linear equation. Inconsistent pair of linear equation. And lines will be like this. They will be parallel. They will not intersect or they will not coincide. Yes, if you draw graph of these lines, so the lines will be parallel. So for at the end, we can write for this type of solution, this lines will intersect. So intersecting lines or lines will intersect because these two types of lines will get, both the lines will intersect. For second one, we can say lines will coincide.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have completed my homework, sir. Can I leave?
No problem. Fine.
Thank you, sir.
You can leave. Thank you. Lines are parallel. So, Anushu, Tushar, any doubt? So, these lines,
no doubt, sir.
This line you will get when you draw the graph. When we have proper equation, we'll see how to draw the graph in our upcoming classes, usually on Friday. Fine. So, you can also end the session. I'm also ending from my side. Try to complete the homework. Thank you.